Tim Ford from Feed Central. Today I want to talk to you about prussic acid and nitrate poisoning as they're serious issues in fodder and grazing production. While prussic acid and nitrates are particularly prevalent in stress sorghum, you can also experience nitrate poisoning in all species. This is why testing is so important. We particularly recommend testing all sorghums and canola, especially where they have been stressed from drought and frost. We also recommend testing all other crops that have been treated with quantities of fertilisers or manures, particularly where these crops are stressed. To give you an example of how serious this issue can be, during the millennial drought, Feed Central experienced a single but devastating incident of livestock death from nitrate poisoning from hay we supplied to a New England grazier. Over the next decade, my team and I researched and spoke to farmers from around the country and found out just how common prussic acid and nitrate poisoning can be. We realised that we needed to design a test that can be performed on the farm by the farmer with instant results. In early 2019, we partnered with Agatel to develop and commercialise the nitrate and prussic acid testing kit. We're now going to head to the Feed Central lab to talk to Kimberly Detmers. Kimberly's going to give us an understanding of the traditional ways to test for prussic acid and nitrate levels within a laboratory environment.
Thanks, Tim. So prussic acid and nitrate poisoning is quite an issue in many regions in Australia. It comes about where excessive levels of prussic acid and nitrate are found in animal feed, largely affecting ruminants. So these two toxins essentially have the same method of action, whereby they replace oxygen in the blood and result in suffocation of the animal at a cellular level. This results in symptoms of labored breathing, of the animal staggering around, of foaming at the mouth. You'll also see discoloured mucous membranes as a result of this oxygen deprivation. If consuming large amounts of these toxins, it can quickly result in the death of these animals as little as 15 minutes after consuming the feed. So prussic acid and nitrates occur naturally in plants. Most of the time they're at safe levels of feed where an animal can digest and safely consume the feed. However, when plants are damaged or stressed, this can increase the levels of prussic acid and nitrates and quickly cause toxicity. So what causes buildup? So you're looking at damage of plants or stress on plants. So that's caused by drought, wilting of the leaves. Frosting can increase prussic acid and nitrate levels in the plant as well. Excessive nitrogen fertilizer applied to a crop can increase prussic acid and nitrate levels, especially where that nitrate isn't utilised by the plant. It stores it as nitrate because it isn't growing, it's stunted by drought. Certain herbicides such as 2,4-D has been linked to increase of prussic acid and nitrate levels as well. For more information on prussic acid and nitrate poisoning, you can jump onto our Feed Central website and find the fact sheets we've developed.
The traditional method of testing is through quantitative means used to determine the specific level of prussic acid or nitrate in a sample in order to determine if the feed may be toxic. Unfortunately, this type of test takes longer to perform, and as a sample is sent to a lab and result turnaround time is easily 1 to 2 weeks, you're looking at levels possibly changing in a standing crop. So this is why we've developed a qualitative prussic acid and nitrate test. It can be performed on paddock and give you a very rapid turnaround of results, a couple of minutes to an hour to get that result. So if you do get a positive result out of your testing kit, we do recommend that you send it into the lab for a quantitative levels test to determine if you have risk of toxicity. So to show you how quick and easy it is to do these tests, we're going to head out into the field with Steve Page.
Thanks, Kimberly. We're now out in the paddock and we're going to grab our samples now for the prussic acid and nitrate test kits. There's quite a variation within this paddock on the moisture where it's struggling in different regions. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and test both areas so we get the variation within the paddock. We try and get enough so that you get a very representative sample of the area. So what we'll do is we'll keep this sample here separate to another sample we'll do down further, because there's a potential we can actually separate this paddock into two. So if we have a negative result down there, we could potentially graze that off. But if this area comes back positive because it's struggling more for moisture, we know that then we have to do something different in this region. The test kit that we send out allows you to be able to do this in the paddock as you're going around the paddock, just to check it as you like. But what we'll do today is go back up to our shed where we're out a bit more of the cold wind and do the tests up there. So here we are back in the shed now, and I've got our nitrate and prussic acid test kit. What we do get in the kit is you get your information sheets. There's some questions in there that you may have that the answers to. Then you've got your cards here, which show you the process that you need to go through to do each test, your prussic acid and all your nitrate, and also your safety side of things. And along with the safety, you also get in here some gloves to be used while you're doing this process. There are 5 prussic acid tests, so you can take a number of samples across the paddock. So we're going to do our nitrate test here, and what I've done is I've got a number of samples of the stem from the paddock, and we cut them open. Open it up, cut it lengthwise, get in there a bit more. So now we apply a drop to each section that's had the stem cut open. If we have an issue with the nitrate, it will turn blue within a couple minutes. So here we are, we've waited our couple minutes after we've placed the drops on there. We have some very minor discoloration from this oats crop that we looked at in the paddock, but nothing to really make a concern. So we would class that as a negative result. So here we are, Kimberly supplied us a canola sample that we had in the lab. We had a negative result with our oats crop, but this is a stem of a canola crop, and you can see that we've had quite a strong result from it. Righto, so now we're here on our prussic acid test. We've got you've got 5 of these bags with the actual little test slip of paper in there. We can grab our sample from where we got out in the paddock. With prussic acid, you're looking more not so much for the stem, but more for the leaf that's in the sample. So what we might do is just cut off that. So this one takes a little bit longer. And the reasoning for that is we put this sample in the bag. We then need a little bit of spray to make it quite humid in the bag to activate the strip. So give it a good 3 or 4 squirts. Seal that up. And we need to put this in a fridge or a ice box. Now that stays in there for about 20 minutes. So here we are, we've had it got it out of the fridge. It's been in there for about 20 minutes. We've got a nice sunny spot here on the bonnet of the car, and we leave it here now for 30 minutes. And at that stage, we should have a result either negative or positive. So here's our sample. It's been in the fridge for about 20 minutes. It's been then on the bonnet of the car for 30 minutes, and we've still come up with a negative result. So that's fine to be grazed. So what we'd like to show you now is a positive result that we had on a different sample that came into the lab that Kimberly has given us. So this is what a positive result will look like. It has a very bright blue stripe down that piece of paper. So that finishes our nitrate and prussic acid test today. It's a very simple, very easy way that you can do it out in the paddock yourself and get an indication of what your crop's doing. But we do recommend that you really do a number of tests across different regions of your paddock so you do get an accurate result. There are very many variabilities in your paddock on compaction, moisture loss, frost risks, just general management of fertilizer and seed and sowing that can affect the stress in different regions of your paddock. So if you do get a positive result, it doesn't tell you the level of the toxicity within the actual crop. But what we do recommend is then you send a sample into the lab, which will give you more detail and a better indication of what that toxicity is.
Thank you, Kimberly and Steve. It's great to see an idea that we had over a decade ago come to fruition. For more information about the different ways to test and about our nitrate and prussic acid testing kits, please get in contact with us.